Welcome back children. Today again we will start with the same lesson, tracing changes through the thousand year. But today we will go to the new topic, that is new social and the political groups. Now children, the period between 700 to 750 was a very great challenge for the historians. Why great challenge? Because number of innovations, number of challenges take place during this period. Now children, when we talk about the new and the old terminologies, let us take the example of the black and white TV. Now black and white TV, after that color TV, and then the computer. So black and white TV was the old terminology, and today computer is the new technology. So you can see the vast changes which take place during the thousand years. So children, at a different moment of time, different innovations take place. One of them was, the most important was the Persian wheel in irrigation. When Persians came to India, they brought the idea of Persian wheel for the irrigation. Before that, Indians were unaware of the use of the Persian wheel. So Persian wheel, which was used for the irrigation, was one of the great innovation. Then second one was the spinning wheel, which was used for weaving. And the third one was the firearm in the combat. So now only I told you that when different groups of people came to India, and with that again there were new innovations in the new food and beverages also. In the eating style also there were changes, in the crops also there were changes. For example, potatoes, corn, chili stick and coffee. So new things like for the food and the beverages also, we see the changes in the food and beverages also. Now children, can you tell me why do we have these innovations during this period? Why do we have the number of changes, number of innovations during this period? Because the group of the people which came to the subcontinent, the group of the people which came to our subcontinent brought the different changes. They came with the new ideas. So the group of the people which came to the subcontinent came with the new ideas, and so we have the different innovations during the years and years. As a result of this, there was a, because of the new innovations, so there was a very vast change in the economic and the political and the social culture also. And therefore this period was also of a great mobility, because as there were new innovations, the economic position of the people also changes, and there was development in the cultural and the social life of the people also. So now why, can you tell me, now we have seen about the new innovations, and why, what were the reasons for the new innovations? The migration of the group of people to the subcontinent. When they came to the subcontinent, they came with the new ideas, and so the new innovations were there. So now can you tell me children, why this group of people came to the subcontinent? So they came to the subcontinent with the some opportunities to gain, because our India, the subcontinent, was very rich in agricultural and trading, etc. So this group of people came to the subcontinent for the various opportunities, trading, etc. Because in the subcontinent they had a chance to change their fortune. And so these people came to the subcontinent and they settled down in our subcontinent. So one of the group who became important during this period was Rajputs. Now the word Rajput has been derived from the word Rajputra. Rajputra means the son of the ruler. Okay, so the Rajputs were they not only belonged to the warriors, but the number of the people, they claimed to be the Kshatriyas, and mostly they belonged to the group of warriors. Now Rajputs were not only the rulers and the chieftains, but also the soldiers and the commanders also in the armies of the different monarchs and all over the subcontinent. Now Rajputs claimed to be Kshatriya clan, and these Rajputs were the very strong rulers and the warriors. Now the other group of the peoples also emerged during this period were Marathas, Sikhs, Jats, Ahoms and the Kayasthas. So these other groups of the rulers also tried to be strong, to make their position strong politically also and economically also. So this way, during this period, the different groups of the people came to the subcontinent and tried to become strong politically also and economically also.
Mohammad Tughlaq, who
fire during this period. And then comes the Ghiyasuddin Balban, who shows his extent of ruling from Bengal in the east to Ghazni in Afghanistan in the west, and included all the South India. Now people of different region come from Goa, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Kerala and Maharashtra, and were ultimately convinced by the local rulers, and so they were adopted to the rulers. Now children, by 700 many regions already possessed the distance, geographical, dimensional and also their own languages. They associated with the ruling dynasties, like with the specific and the ruling dynasties. Occasionally the dynasties like the Cholas, Khiljis and the Tughlaqs and the Mughals were able to build their whole empire. Slowly and slowly, gradually and gradually, after year and years, these dynasties became stronger and stronger, and they tried to show their own political influence in the kingdom. But after the Mughals, when the Mughals declined in the 18th century, there were regional states that were brought up. The entire empire started to get to the local. The local rulers started showing their own power, and the whole region was divided in the pan-regional states. In the pan-regional. So the local rulers started establishing their control, and they started influencing the local people at the same time, and they were influenced by the pan-regional. Now these regions felt the impact of the local rulers, pan-regionals, and the forces of the integration without ever losing their prosperity, even their distinction.